Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning to the AFPD in the group. I'd like to follow up on the AFP Modernization Fund. May we know, Mr. Secretary, Mr. Chairman, the fund generated during the Ramos administration, ERA, PGMA, and as of today, the Pinoy administration.
I'm sorry, Your Honor, what we have today, the total amount generated for the modernization program.
But I'm sorry also, but I'm asking for the specific amounts.
The total,
I'm sure you have that somewhere.
Yes, Your Honor. The total amount provided to the armed forces for its modernization is 48 billion. 300 million pesos, Your Honor.
Yes, but I would like the amount per administration.
Can you be given time to submit it?
Yes, but I'd like to have that now. But meantime, I'll proceed with my other questions and awaiting the research by the panel. May proceed with my next question. And this is also the 2+2 meeting that the Secretary of Defense had with Secretary Panetta, Secretary Rosario, and Secretary Clinton in Washington, D.C. And after the 2+2, Secretary Clinton, I think Secretary Panetta, also announced that the U.S. is increasing its military assistance to $30 billion. And they also announced the delivery of the additional Coast Guard cutter. And that sounded impressive at that time. However, Mr. Chairman, I ran into this news article from Indonesia that in November last year, there was a comprehensive partnership agreement framework between President Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono and President Obama, where the U.S. Government, on a grant basis, would turn over second-hand F-16 fighters. Of course, the rejuvenation, they use the term rejuvenation and regeneration will be underwritten by the Indonesian government. But 24 F-16s, what would be the ballpark figure for 24 F-16s, Mr. Secretary, compared to our $30 million?
Thank you, Your Honor. We received the information regarding this transaction between the U.S. government and the Indonesian government, that it is in the form of a procurement, Your Honor. The amount that is the amount that we recall is $700 million. The Indonesian government will be shouldering $700 million for those 24 F-16s.
I'm sorry, but the information I have is that it is a grant. In fact, I'd like to follow through by saying that in addition to that, there was another announcement by your counterpart, Mr. Secretary, the Minister of Defense of Indonesia, that there will be an additional, maybe 1 to 2 squadrons of F-16s, also on a grant basis. Now, the reason I ask this, Mr. Chairman, is that I think we are closer to what a lot of people are looking at as a potential regional security concern, the South China Sea. Indonesia is a little far down as far as the South China Sea is concerned. The closest is the Natuna Sea. But in the case of the Philippines, it is it's right there as far as the freedom of navigation concern aspect, which is always the matter being discussed when it comes to the South China Sea. So the question is, why is this so? Are we negotiating effectively here, or are we just getting crumbs when it comes to $30 million? That's practically one F-16 only.
Your Honor, well, it was labeled as a grant. The Indonesian government will have to shoulder $650 million.
Yes, that's for the rejuvenation, and the technical term they use is rejuvenation and regeneration. So I guess if it's 24 times 600, that would turn out to maybe from about 20 to $30 million per copy,
which we cannot afford. What we have, when they gave us the copy, it was also told that they were.
We had that opportunity also, Mr. Secretary, to take delivery of something comparable to that, maybe smaller, depending on our capability to refurbish this using our own budget.
We are looking at the cost, Your Honor, and simply because we cannot afford, and after the assessment, the F-16s that were that will be given to Indonesia is not the remaining flight time is not certain, so that after refurbishing all these things with an amount of $650 million, it will come out to be very expensive if the flying time will only be good for two years.
So you are telling us, Mr. Secretary, that there was an opportunity for us also.
Yes, you're
avail of this excess defense article from the U.S.
Yes, sir.
Except that we have a bigger budgetary constraint. But what is our defense budget compared to the Indonesian defense budget? Is there a comparison? Again, maybe the research group can look this up while I'm asking questions, Chairman. May I just continue on another topic? And this is the comparative cost of a locally manufactured ammo compared with imported from, let's say, Korea, or Singapore, or Pakistan. M1, how much is the price of the M1? The transfer from the arsenal to the AFP as well as the KNK, compared to how much it would be imported landed cost. Do we have that figure? Also for 9mm and the 7.62.
The cost of our ammunition, sir.
Yes. Yes, sir. Compared to imported ammunition.
The latest we have of the AFP procurement service almost the same as ours, sir, for the government arsenal service. For the 5.56 ball, it's 21.22. And it is the same cost as we have now. Although this increase, we used to be lower, but the increase of our fourth tranche this year increased the cost of our production because of labor, sir.
No, I think we used to be bigger, locally manufactured. I remember a few years back, used to be about 30% bigger.
Yes, sir. But we had increased our production since then, sir. The more you increase your production, the cost, labor cost normally goes down.
Thank you. That's good. So this is the same for all kinds of major ammunition articles?
Yes, sir. The different variants from the SS-109, the M193 ball, 7.62 link ammunition, and match ammunition, sir.
Now, another question, Mr. Secretary, with respect to accidents, air accidents. Maybe not the record of aircraft accidents for the Philippine Air Force, and including the other units of the AFP, because the Philippine Navy has flying assets also. I would suppose the Philippine Army for the year, the present year, 2012, and how many fatalities resulted from these accidents?
Sir, good morning. Sir, for this year, the most, we have so far one major fatality, which is the SF-260 turboprop in Sangli. Although we have not officially declared them, because they're still missing, one has already been recovered. That's one of the most of us, the others are really more of an incident, wherein there was not really loss of lives, but more of the equipment. And we're looking at the exact figure, but what would be happy to know, sir, is from the last 5 years, we have actually drastically reduced the number of incidents of the Air Force. And this has been also an outlier result of the aggressive inputs of some of my predecessors in terms of safety intervention.
Thank you. And may we know, is there a finding already on the reason for the trainer plane accident in the Bataan area?
Sir, actually, that would be the biggest question mark, because we have not yet identified the location of the aircraft. And we need to recover the aircraft, because there will be no live testimonies from the pilots.
Thank you. Now, my next question is, may we be educated on the Italian equipment that we're importing to the Philippine Navy, Mr. Secretary?
You're talking of the Maestrale.
Thank you very much, Your Honor. What is being proposed, Your Honor, is the acquisition of the Maestrale class frigates of the Italian Navy. We are looking at a possible acquisition of two of these frigates. These are commissioned in 1980s, early 80s, Your Honor. This is a gross tonnage of 3,000 tons with a length of about 378 feet. And this is already equipped with weapon system. It is equipped with an octopod launcher of the SPD, and then it has a 127mm automatic guns, and a couple of autobreda 40mm anti-aircraft guns. It is basically a ship that is designed for an anti-submarine operations. It has a sonar and can carry two anti-submarine warfare helicopters at any one time. The propulsion system, Your Honor, is a cod dog, meaning to say it's a combination of diesel or gas. On a diesel engine, it can do a 12 to 40 knots steaming run. And in cases of emergency, where it would need a fast movement, it can go to as high as 25 knots using the gas turbine engines, Your Honor.
And we will know the approximate budget for this. What is the status of this project?
The status of the project, Your Honor, it's still going through the system of what we call the defense acquisition system under the defense system of management. It is being vetted with other possible options, comparative that is to other possible assets of comparable capability, but right now it's turning out to be a very good viable option as a step up capability upgrade. The budget is still not definite, Your Honor, because it will still be subject to negotiations with both governments, the Italian and the Philippine government.
So they were built in the 1980s.
Yes, Your Honor.
So this will be comparable to the FFG-7s that I understand are available in the market also?
Yes, Your Honor. It is basically comparable to the FFGs, but the main difference, Your Honor, is the FFGs are a gas turbine dedicated propulsion system, in which case it would be very, very expensive for us to maintain such kind of a ship.
Can we go back to the AFP modernization plan?
Just one question. Admiral, what are the names of the ships? The two ships that you're negotiating?
The length, Your Honor.
The names?
The names. We are looking at the possibly the Maestrale. And
the name of the specific ship.
Yes, Your Honor. Because it's called the Maestrale class, because this is the first unit that was named with that kind of ship. And if I'm not mistaken, the other one is.
It was laid down 1978, launched in February
1981. Sirocco. I think Sirocco, Your Honor.
Sirocco is the fourth ship.
Yes, Your Honor.
F573.
Yes, Your Honor.
Were they specifically getting rid of these two ships and not the others?
The Italian government, Navy right now, Your Honor, is undertaking what they call the FREM, the upgrading of their two destroyers. And they are now in the process of decommissioning these kind of ships. And some of the Maestrale type ships have already started undergoing through the FREM process, meaning the upgrading. And I think the Maestrale, the Sirocco, is not yet in part of that FREM system. So they are now in the market, Your Honor.
Do they have any cruising weapon systems?
Yes, Your Honor. They're using the Automelar Queen 40mm weapon system on both sides, port and starboard. This is their equivalent to the SEWIS, the closing weapon system of the Goalkeeper of the United States. But they don't use the Goalkeeper. They do not use that, Your Honor. Instead, they're using this twin Automelar 40mm.
What's the rate of fire?
We'll check on that, Your Honor, the specific.
Goalkeeper's 30mm.
I'm sorry, Your Honor.
The goalkeeper's 30mm.
Yes,
1000 RPM. What is the Automelara's rate of fire?
I'll check on this the specific rate.
Because what is the approximate price of the ship?
The approximate price right now that you're talking about, Your Honor, is about 6 billion.
6 billion?
Yes, Your Honor.
For each?
Yes, Your Honor.
For each ship?
Yes, Your Honor. That would include, all encompassing, Your Honor, to include the training of the whole crew, which would be. Because that price, Your Honor, will include the refurbishing of the ship to what we call the zero time.
Okay, what about the fire control systems?
The fire control system, Your Honor, they're still working. The combat management system, Your Honor.
But these are old.
Yes, Your Honor. I think they have a lifespan of until 2017, Your Honor.
Are there any options on how much it would cost to improve the fire control systems to shoot down a cruise missile?
Actually, that's now part of the study that we are undertaking, Your Honor. By 2017, when the fire control system of the existing Maestrale will already be out of the market, the options, because the pricing will also be determined by the options of what we're going to put into that ship, Your Honor. For example, yung ngayon po, kung papalitan na po yun, 2016 or 2017, yung pressure din po ng ipapalit natin will be dependent on the capability of the system that we will put in.
Can I just continue? My question is on the AFP modernization budget per administration.
During the time of President Estrada, the amount given to the armed forces is about 5.4 billion pesos, according to our record. There was none during the time of President Ramos. 33 billion was during the time of President Gloria Arroyo, and about 28 billion during the time of President Aquino.
Just to summarize, just to make sure that my notes here, Ramos administration, zero.
That's correct, Your Honor.
President Estrada, 5.4 billion.
That's correct.
And the GMA, 33 billion. And present administration, 28 billion. And we are expecting more. When do we expect the additional under the present administration? Is there an indication already?
The 5 billion is already included in the 2013 budget, in the national expenditure program for 2013. An additional 10 billion is included in the program fund.
Thank you. Now, my final question, Mr. Chairman, Mr. Sikarati. During the time of General Oban, we had a conversation on the possibility of using land-based missiles to protect our exclusive economic zone, especially towards the west, with a range of maybe 150 nautical miles, not beyond 200 nautical miles. And looking at the possible budget, this seems to be a very good asymmetrical option for the AFP. Considering the kind of threat that we may be encountering in the coming years, is this still being considered, Mr. Secretary?
Yes, Your Honor. This is part of the discussion of senior leaders and the defense officials in what we call the defense system of management. We're studying all these possibilities.
How firm is this now? What time frame are we talking about here? Because we cannot, you know, if we're looking at the possible threat to the west or a little bit north, it's going to be very difficult to match them frigate by frigate or plane by plane. We'd be obliterated maybe in 12 hours' time or less. But with that land-based missile system, maybe we have a better chance. In the same way that they are also considering this asymmetrical approach in, for example, neutralizing threats from aircraft carriers using missiles also, like the Dongfeng missiles.
In terms of priority, Your Honor, the Maestrale or the ships, the frigates, will be given priority over the land-based missiles.
What would be the range of the missiles of the Italian frigates? Are these anti-ship missiles, or can it target fixed targets, let's say, mystically, about 130 nautical miles away?
The missiles of these ships, Your Honor, are basically anti-ship missiles. But if you be
basically over the horizon,
it has an over the horizon capability, Your Honor.
Can it go beyond 100 nautical miles?
I doubt it, Your Honor.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.